Hi guys, it's AndroidPipe.com and I'm here with a game called Thor The Dark World. It's available from Gameloft. It's available for free. And as you can see, you can play in all the famous universes that Thor explores. For now, I have reached this one. This game is your typical action title. If it were on a console, I would call it a button mashing title, but here it's a screen mashing affair. It takes up about 1.6 gigabytes of storage on your device, and let's get straight to the action, and then we'll talk about upgrades, abilities, allies, and all that. Thor The Dark World comes from Gameloft. It's available for free. It's inspired by the movie with the same name that was in the cinemas, and I'm playing it on a Nexus 5. As you can see, great graphics. It resembles God of War and Diablo a little bit, if you want a comparison. Okay, so we have some objectives at the start of a mission. And this is the almighty god Thor. In order to move him around, you simply tap the screen. He reaches a certain area. In order to interact with objects, you tap on them. So it's all tapping, tapping, and tapping. Of course, double taps have different effects. You can do a lightning sign to trigger an ability. You can also see the weaknesses here. Some enemies are weak towards certain types of allies that you can summon. And if you press this button, you can summon these two guys here. So you get the idea. It's all tap, tap, and tap again. Thor has a couple of hits that will upgrade. Usually he just swings his hammer. And if you press this button here, that's the special ability. He conjures lightning. You'll also run into traps, usually based on fire, at least in this universe. This is a fire trap. By the way, if you stay from the distance and try to avoid the fire, you can double tap the screen and throw your hammer. So with the dual tap, you can throw the hammer, stay away, and keep safe. And also avoid the traps that shoot at the distance. The music is pretty good in this game. Dramatic music. Well, the movie was pretty funny, not that dramatic. Typical God of War action, button mashing. Only this is the God of Thunder and not the God of War. I just freed one more soldier. And in this mission, I must free soldiers, but in other missions I can summon them. And now I can use my Thunder power yet again. As you can see, the graphics are beautiful. And in some way, I'm pretty sure that the game sticks to the story of the movie. There are even some bosses. You can see that we got here this big guy. He's made of stone. And at some point, I will be fighting some sort of lava demons. And I just called some soldiers to help me. You can withdraw and throw your hammer a bunch of times. You can also use a potion. But as you can see, you have to spend money if you are out of potions. At the end of his mission, there is a tower to destroy. It's the enemy's base. And the idea is to finish it off in order to end the mission. I think I'm going to be destroyed now, so this is a mission that's been lost. Of course, you can pay, resurrect, and continue fighting the enemies. Don't get me wrong, this is a pretty hard game to play, but it's fun at the same time. I'm comparing it, as I said earlier, to God of War meets a bit of Diablo. At least in the fire levels. Thor has special powers and you can access those by tapping the screen and accessing gestures. So this is the window dedicated to Thor. You can upgrade him and these are some of the armors that you can use. Some of the weapons that you can use, a variety of hammers. Then you can get back and access his skill tree. Pretty complex skill tree, as you can see here, a lot of abilities to unlock. Most of them costs money and resources that you'll never get to have in this game. Then there are the allies. These are the people that will fight side by side with you. I can see that Odin is here and some of the other mates that you saw in the movie. What annoys me the most here is that your allies, when beaten, will take too long to heal. For example, this guy, well, it took him about a couple of days to heal. Some of them take 60 hours or so, which is huge for a game you want to play only a few minutes per day. These are the soldiers that you can call to your aid during missions. All of them can be upgraded. Your allies can be upgraded. Your soldiers can be upgraded. The skill tree is huge, so there's a lot of variety when it comes to pimping your superhero. And I mean customizing him, not taking him to the ladies. Okay, so another mission. There are some promos and recommendations of special abilities. These are the allies I can call. And this is my fellow mate warrior. You can also upgrade your damage and hit points. No, I don't want to spend real money. Not yet. And let's see another mission. The graphics of the game and the soundtrack are almost perfect. There's nothing to object here. There are even cutscenes and some cute boss battles. But the game is very, very hard. I just called some spearmen, some Valkyries and some foot soldiers, and now the battle will get really started. Thor just perform a combo, and the idea in this mission is to defend the base. You can also find chests with coins, and when things get tough you can always use the power of lightning. And you can summon even more soldiers. You can pretty much figure out what the system is here. You tap to walk, you tap to attack, and you tap here to call more units. Then you tap here for the special power, and you tap here for your allies' special power. Some of your allies can heal you or improve your combat. We have a lot of soldiers here, so I guess we're not going to lose this mission. That simply involves defending this base. There are various other sub-objectives, like simply killing a number of enemies, keeping your hit points above 70%, or finding a special object or stuff like that. This game is Thor: The Dark World. It gets a 9 out of 10 from us because it's a very well done game, but it requires you to spend too much, both time and money, to actually proceed in the game further. So 9 out of 10 for Thor: The Dark World. Very fun game, but you have to spend and be patient to grind enough. That's it from AndroidPipe.com. Bye bye.